Hello, everyone. I hope you're enjoying this event. My name is Rachel Williams, and I'm a product marketing manager at Microsoft. Now we're going to introduce you to an incredible educator who truly embodies the spirit of this event with his passion for equity and knack for ingenuity. Major Alan Williams knows the importance of utilizing the right tools for education that can dramatically transform any learning experience. Thank you so much for joining us today, Major Williams. We are so excited to hear about your story and what's next for you and your students.
Well, thank you, Rachel. I'm really pleased to be here today.
Yes, we are so happy to have you. So to get things started, could you tell us a little more about yourself and your journey from the Air Force to Aberdeen High School?
Sure, absolutely. I spent 25 years in the Air Force, starting out as an enlisted person, actually completed my degree while in the Air Force and became a commissioned officer. After retirement and being a native Mississippian, I was looking for a way that I would be able to give back to, you know, the state that had given me the opportunities that I had had. I found my way into the junior ROTC program, but I am here at Aberdeen High School, Aberdeen, Mississippi, and just really having a good time and doing some interesting things.
So we would love to hear about how you and your students got involved with CS for All.
Almost purely by chance. Part of my journey into the junior program, I had spent time at Tuskegee University teaching at the college level for ROTC and came across a lot of students that had found the college ROTC purely by chance. So my interest in getting into this, into a program like this, was to try to help make that less a by chance situation for students and more on purpose. I know as an educator and have seen even in my Air Force career how important it is for maybe disadvantaged students who didn't have all of the bells and whistles, all of the tools at their disposal, and how that can, you know, create an environment where they're just behind. And with that in mind, I was kind of on the lookout for opportunities where we could really expand the horizons of what we offer here at the high school. Purely by chance, I came across an article that talked about the new partnership that had been established between headquarters, Air Force Junior ROTC, and CS for All. You know, we were added and became one of only 30 high schools across the country to be part of this pilot program.
Wow, that sounds like a great opportunity for you and your students, and that is just amazing. So as we know, COVID has impacted a lot of learning experience, and everybody has had to adjust to very new realities and new normals. So can you speak to the transition at your high school to remote and hybrid learning?
Well, and I understand and realize that not everybody was sitting in a junior ROTC program. Not everybody had a military background and all like mine. But I think the common thread, the thing that was most in common for all of us, is just the fact that COVID just created chaos for all of us. That's what we had to try to start working through to get where we wanted to go. We literally had just left kind of the kickoff for this junior ROTC CS for All initiative in mid-February, left for spring break, and the kids literally never came back. Even when we did come back in the fall, we didn't come back in the world that we had left in March. So that just really became an effort on the part of the staff and all here as to how are we going to continue on with that objective of creating this better environment. But more than that, though, and our school, like a lot of schools, I think throughout the state, especially, and across the country, came back and realized we didn't have students with devices of any type at home. Our district invested the funds and started providing some web-based devices, but they were not as capable, I'll say, as what we really needed to do to promote the type of really advanced computer science and cyber studies that we envisioned. Mm-hmm.
Yes, you made a great point about all of us having this common feeling about things being a little chaotic, but it's still important to prioritize accelerated learning. So how do you think using Windows-based technology has really prepared your students for the future?
Oftentimes you will hear coaches, especially, and I'll speak from an athletics point of view, and they will talk about the need to practice the way they want to play. Mm-hmm. Which means that you need the type of equipment to practice on that you're actually going to compete with. So we looked at, okay, so what would it take for us to really create an environment more in line with what our students might experience when they go out into the workplace? And then we were fortunate enough to land a grant that allowed us to get a nice assortment of Windows-based Dell laptops that we were then able to bring in. And it's made that process and that transition that much easier because now the students were working on devices that was in line with what the industry would expect out in the workplace. It just really enhanced the ability for our students to understand concepts and to learn concepts that become directly transferable because of the right device in front of them.
I totally agree. I love that model, and it's very applicable to all areas of life, and I think that's a really great distinction. So as we wrap up in our final question here, we would love to hear about your goals and your visions for the future of computer science at your high school.
Well, and I think one of the themes that resonated in the initial kickoff for this pilot program was they talked about making, in essence, a district-wide plan. And if you consider, we focused on the high school, but we also have to have a vision for the students that are coming up into the high school. And we have kind of set on the mindset that the better and more capable we make our middle school students and even our elementary age students, the higher the bar is when they get to high school. So the higher we can push them in that development chain. While we have focused on developing a menu of computer science type classes, we're also looking at engaging with our middle school students. There are some different competitions that we're able to participate in the junior ROTC program that we're looking to at least expose our middle school students to. And then also with our, again, our elementary age students, we were very fortunate this past summer to have and to host here in junior ROTC the community's first ever Generation Cyber Camp, 5-day camp for students that were in fourth through sixth grade.
Absolutely. That was such an incredible and powerful vision for the future, and really just a testament to the importance of representation and diversity in STEM. So thank you so much for sharing. It has been an absolute pleasure speaking with you. And thank you for sharing your story and your experience and all of your insights. And thank you for your service as well. And I wish you and your students the best school year ever.
Well, thank you, Rachel. It was really great. And we greatly appreciate this opportunity to, you know, to tell our story a bit.
Thank you so much.